Hello dear viewers, welcome to e-learning. Subscribe to our SAOP Academic YouTube channel and turn on notification. Dear viewers, this video deals with the clinical research protocol, the topic 9 from the syllabus framed by Swami Ramanathan Marathwada University Nanded for the 4th year B Pharmacy at semester. Subject is clinical pharmacy and drug interaction. Subject code is BPH87. The contents are introduction, contents of the research protocol as per ICH E3 GCP 6 guideline. What is a protocol amendment? What is a protocol violation? And some of the summary of the key points associated with the clinical research protocol. This particular video deals with the introductory details associated with the clinical research protocol. When we want to carry out a clinical research, we require a set of series of documents. What is the purpose of document? The document that will ensure the standardization. And standardization is nothing but the process in which everyone doing the same thing in the same way. Standardization is critical in a clinical research study and particularly critical for the multi-site trials. Research that is not conducted in a standardized manner is unethical because it may put research participants at risk while yielding the invalid data. Protection of the safety, rights and well-being of research participant is discussed in the introduction, institutional review board and the informed consent modules. Several documents are key to ensuring that a research study is conducted in a standardized manner. That is the documents and the record keeping of for a full list of essential study documents. All research staff that participates in a clinical study must be familiar with and must strictly adhere to the procedures described in these documents. The various list of documents are investigator's brochure, operations manual, standard operating procedures, other study documents, research protocol, and the reason why research is important or why it is to be carried out. So investigator's brochure, it is a document containing non-clinical and clinical data to describe the previous experiences with the experimental intervention of a medication type. Operations manual, the operations manual operationalizes the protocol, providing more detail on the actual procedures needed to perform in the research. For example, the protocol might specify that a urine sample is to be collected at each study visit, whereas the operations manual would describe details of the collection, labeling, storage and shipping of the samples. For another example, the operations manual might state that each study site is to maintain a site contact log containing the names, addresses and phone numbers of all individuals involved in the study at that site. Additionally, even more detailed information such as a list of staff responsible for maintaining the contact log and the detailed procedures involved would be appropriate for an operation manual. However, such details would be inappropriate in the research protocol. The standard operating procedures. These will describe in detail how the specific procedures that are to be carried out, for example, taking vital signs, performing urine tests, and assessing adverse events in the research study. Most SOPs will be identical for all study sites. However, in some cases, site-specific variations that are needed. For example, if procedures for handling a medical emergency vary slightly from one research site to another, the SOP for these procedures at a specific site will reflect those variations. Additionally, site staff will need to be trained appropriately for the site-specific procedures. Other study documents this involves. This module focuses on the research protocol. Some information may be provided in other documents that accompany the protocol, such as the investigator's brochure. Additional site-specific information that may change during the trial, such as names and addresses of the research sites and the sponsor's medical expert information, may be provided in a separate document, such as the operations manual. This is acceptable as long as the protocol contains a language that refers to the operations manual for this information. The research protocol. Research protocol provides a plan for the essential aspects of the proposed research. It must be approved by the designated institutional review board, that is IRB, before the research can begin. Any changes to the protocol must be approved by the IRB. The reason that why the research protocol is so important. Again, this is the important document. The research protocol is one of the main documents that must be approved by the designated institutional review board before any research study that can begin. The good clinical practices GCP guidelines of the International Council for Harmonization requires a research protocol for any study that involves human participants. In addition, Title 21 Part 312 of the Code of Federal Regulations 21 CFR 312 that will describe both a research protocol and protocol amendments for studies conducted under an investigational new drug application. For further reading, viewers can go through the references given on this page. And in this video, we saw the introductory details related with the clinical research protocol. Thank you very much for watching. Take care and happy e-learning.